So, you should know two things about me. One, I love romantic movies. And two, I was raised in Mumbai, the land of Bollywood. And I've always wanted for something in my life to be a lot like a Bollywood movie. And that didn't happen until I moved to the land of Hollywood. It all happened when I bought my first Groupon. Yoga classes in Beverly Hills half off. Now, Mr. Yoga and I date back several years, several thousands of years. We were born in the same country, and that was serendipity waiting to happen. My parents were huge fans of Mr. Yoga, and after several years of resisting him, I gave in to the magical words half off. I reached for my date on time, I opened the door. I was consumed by this torrid, sweltering steam. I then learned it was hot yoga, which almost never happens in India. I went in and my naturally curly hair poofed up into a disgusting mane because of the humidity. I tucked myself away to a very corner of the room, and then I discovered something. The room was annoyingly hot, yes, but every girl in the room was annoyingly hot. It was Beverly Hills. And the class began, and we rose and fell into the downward facing dog, and I couldn't handle it. Like, my hands were clammy, sweaty, my hair was just out of control. I didn't have any upper body strength, as you can see. So I literally slammed and fell face down. I was the downward facing underdog in the class. And it wasn't working well. The more I did it, the more I began crying, and tears just streamed down my clammy, disgusting, sweaty cheeks, and I walked out of there. Clearly, my date with Mr. Yoga was not going well. So I chose to not call him for a while. My friend said, "Hey, you know, something can cheer you up. There's this guy, and being with him is a party." And then I went on my first date with Mr. Zumba. Now, Mr. Zumba and I didn't have a common language. He spoke Spanish and I don't. But there's something so sexy about a man who speaks a foreign language. And Mr. Zumba was young and happy and loved to dance. Together we did the salsa, the cumbia, merengue. Sometimes we'd get down and dirty with the hip-hop beats, and I was not complaining. Some other times it was belly dancing, and I never grew up to this kind of dance, but the one thing I can tell you is when I'm on the Zumba floor, my hips don't lie. I loved being with Mr. Zumba. I mean, I could let my hair down, my curly hair just feathered away with the music. I just transformed into this courageous, confident Indian Shakira. I was a diva. I loved being on center stage because nobody puts baby in the corner. That night, I pondered about my one-of-a-kind love triangle. Mr. Yoga, with whom I had so much in common and my parents approved of him. Mr. Zumba, that I had nothing in common with and my parents questioned his legitimate existence. Mr. Yoga, who has thousands of years worth of a track record. And Mr. Zumba was young and wild and free. Can I trust him? What does a girl do? What does any girl in a romantic movie do? She waits for a sign from the universe. So that Saturday, I paid extra attention to the words of a Mark Anthony song in my Zumba class. The song went like this. Voy a reír, voy a bailar, vivir mi vida, la, 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 la. That means, I'm gonna dance, I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna live my life. That very instant, I knew the sign. The sign was, in life, just like in your workouts, it's not about finding someone who is perfect, but it's finding someone with whom you feel perfect. And Mr. Zumba and I lived happily ever after. Thank you.